All right, everybody. It's Saturday, March the 20th, and you're listening to the live studio session of The Cutting Edge, live every Saturday night at 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Send your questions or comments to digitaladdiction@gmail.com or on Skype, message the username digitaladdiction. You can also listen to the show on TalkShoe, the name Digital Addiction. Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow, Sunday, the attempt to pass the health care bill. It would be another sad day in America when the health care bill is passed. Next to the Patriot Act, it's one of the worst bills. Talk about sinister. Extremely unconstitutional, downright illegal, and sickening. We are definitely living in some strange times, make no mistake about it. We are back live on The Cutting Edge, and I hope you're with us. And here is Eddie, if he has his microphone connected properly. We have Patrick, Richard, and our co-host Darko live with us here on Saturday night.
Okay, Eddie, check in.
Hello, can you hear me?
Hey, we can hear you.
Hear you just fine, too.
All right, excellent. Great show.
Okay, what's your take on the health care, Eddie? We haven't heard from you yet.
Well, I think the Democrats will go for broke and try to pass it. The liberals in this country have waited a long time to do this, and I think they know their time is running out, and they're not going to get reelected. So I think they're going to do a kamikaze nosedive with this and just pass it anyway.
See, and you know, the more I kind of delve into this, I'm inclined to think that we're going to see a false flag before it hits election time. And quite possibly, we're going to get nailed with the old keyword Marshall.
Yeah.
Christ, I hope.
Yeah, because Obama's pushing, and everybody knew this. That right, you know, when he got the health care bill, even though he hasn't quite got it yet, it's probably definitely in the bag. That he was immediately going to go after legalizing the illegals, and sure enough, that's what I'm seeing all over the place. So I really feel that they'll do a false flag to get people's minds off of what's going on, number one, and to use it as an excuse to implement martial law, which in essence is going to cease all and any voting privileges, because that's in essence what voting is today, is a privilege.
I agree. I think you're correct, and I'm sure you guys are familiar with Gerald Celente of the Trends Research Institute, and he had been calling for 2010 to be a year of terror, and I'm concerned about something, a false flag type of event to kick off this war with Iran. I know the Israelis that control the foreign policy of the United States have been foaming at the mouth to get this war started for quite some time. They just need the right provocation, and they need to shift the blame away from the Zionist banking cartel and towards back on the Arabs with the war on terror. So
I think their perfect chess move here
is to, you know, destroy a city. I don't know what the scale will be, whether it'll be smaller than 9/11 or bigger.
It's going to be bigger.
They just need something, and I hope it's not bigger, but they need something to shift the blame and attention away from the criminal gang that's running our country and onto the Arabs.
Well, I mean, let's you know, look at it in a logical sense. It has to be bigger because we're already desensitized, you know, to lose 3,000 at one time. So, I mean, we're used to that. You know, it has to go into the tens of thousands this time.
Sure,
I tell you what, I don't know if you guys know this or not, but there are liquid natural gas tankers coming in from where is it, Somalia or something. This is where, you know, the coal is on fire in the Middle East. But evidently Homeland Security has it under control. They're checking out all the workmen on these tankers and so forth and so on. But these tankers have to come up the Charles River, I think, and unload in the middle of the city. And if one of those things goes off, it will probably affect 100,000 plus people.
Well, I'll tell you what, Richard, you just gave the in-flight terrorists a good idea.
No, I didn't give anybody an idea. The newspaper's been educating me. it's the common everyday newspaper that's and everybody's worried about it here in Boston. I mean, if one of those things goes off, it will affect everybody within a 3 or 4 mile radius.
Yeah, I mean, and that's something pretty simple to do too. And like what Eddie said, that was what my next thought process was: is that they need something to start something with Iran.
Right. Yeah. And I know you guys have heard the stories in the past couple of years about B-17 bombers flying and missing nuclear mm-hmm. bombs. Yep. You know, there are companies that we outsource to guard our military infrastructure in a lot of cases. And a lot of these companies are run by Israelis. There are Israeli-owned companies, just like the security systems at Boston Logan Airport on 9/11 were run by Israeli firms. And there was an Israeli just a week or two ago that was on Fox News talking about how there's going to be an attack on American soil soon. And I think they're just priming the public for it. And we've seen a lot of lone wolf attacks so far this year. And you know, that's their greatest weapon is the mass media and these little provocations that they can use to pinprick the public to get them riled up, and they can get people riled up to the point where they'll support anything, including World War III. Christian Zionists in this country, they're ready to go bomb Iran and start World War III. And you hear Russia saying, we're going to get into it. If you start with Iran, Russia, Putin, and Medvedev are going to bring their chips into this gamble here. This is bad stuff.
Yeah, and you have to take, you know, into consideration there's definitely some validity to what you're saying, because if people can remember back to 9/11, how many Israelis were in the World Trade Center building? There was absolutely none.
Right, there was only one that died, and I think he was on one of the flights.
Well, I'm kind of hard pressed to believe that there was.
Yeah, well, that's what they say. I agree with you. Right. In New York City, the financial district, I think they said that those two buildings, those twin towers, could hold about 80,000 to 100,000 people, and there were reports that. Instant messaging services, Odigo and ICQ, I believe, were used to get the message out to Israelis and Hebrew speakers through a search function to not go to work on 9/11 because something was going to happen.
Exactly. Yeah, I was curious, maybe somebody might know, but I remember that there was individuals that had instituted shorts on the stock market for that particular day, and when I last heard, nobody has collected that money, and that was like over a year ago.
I believe that was the Saudis that did that. They shorted American Airlines, United Airlines, and somebody else. They could have made a big killing.
Yeah, and from what my information. And, was,